Hello, good morning students. Say, welcome back to our e-learning session. And this is your second lecture of chapter number 8, Journal Proper Accounts, right? Now, see, in our last session, we saw the illustration number 1 and the general theory about the journal proper, the types 1, 2, 3, that is, transactions not including the other subsidiary books. And under that, the subparts first, that is credit purchase or credit sales of assets and profit or loss and its sale, that portion that we will discuss, and also the transactions for which subsidiary books are not kept, that transactions we also discuss, as well as here in the last session we complete illustration number 1. Now the third sub point of the transactions not included in other subsidiary books is here, C point, special transactions not recorded in the other subsidiary books. See, the transactions not recorded in subsidiary books which are not kept, that is so in our last session, that is B point. Now the special transactions which has no any subsidiary books right now, that means here the subsidiary books is purchase book, sales book, purchase return book, sales return book, then bills receivable, bills payable, cash book and journal proper. Okay, so here up to journal proper, all the 7 subsidiary books are not here. That means here, if the all the 7 subsidiary books are kept, but the transactions which are a special transactions which is not included in these 7 subsidiary books is a special transactions, and now it is recorded in journal proper. What is that? See, I'm reading that first. Some special transactions are not recorded in the any subsidiary books, so they are not record, they are recorded in the journal proper. For example, first, goods given in a charity. See, goods goes out other than sales or purchase return. I told you at the time of journal entries, that is chapter number 4. Whenever the goods goes out other than sales or purchase return from the business, all are a special transactions. That means what? The transactions, that is, for example, goods given for a charity, goods given for advertisement, that is free sample, goods taken away for a personal use, goods destroyed by fire. Okay, so just like that, all the transactions, goods goes out from the business other than sales or purchase return is a special transaction, and that's why here it is recorded in journal proper. Okay, so first, goods given in a charity, goods given as a sample, goods taken for personal use, and dishonor of bill. See, if bills receivable we are written, then it is recorded in the bills receivable book, that is bills receivable issue, that is recorded in bills receivable book if we are kept out the bills receivable book as a subsidiary book. But if the bills receivable book is not there, then bills receivable is also recorded in journal proper, as well as the dishonored of the bills receivable. That means, what means of that? See, if I am the I'm explaining you the full transaction. See here, first, say for example, R sold the goods to G. R sold the goods to G of rupees 10,000, right? R sold the goods to G of rupees 10,000. Now what? R goes to G for the money after 10 to 15 days. Here, goods sold on a credit basis, credit sales. Okay, so here, goods sold on the credit basis to G, 10,000, and R goes to G after 10 to 15 days for the money. G refused, I have no money. Then what? R issue a bills receivable on G, and G accept it and return it. Accept, sign, and accept and return to R. R draw or R issue a bills receivable on G, and G sign it and return it, accept, sign and return it to For the month, see here, the tenure is 2 months. Now 2 months extra credit is given. Here, first 10 to 15 days credit is given by R2G for 10,000 rupees. Okay. After that, R goes to G and G refuse to give a money. Then at that time, R issue a bill issuable on G for the next 2 months period. Right? But at the time of maturity, that means after 2 months, R again goes to G and asks for the money, 10,000 rupees, same amount, nothing else, 2 months extra credit is also given. But now at that time also, that means after 2 months also, G refused to give the money, he has no money. Okay, so what, at that time the G refused, it is called a dishonor of bill. Okay, whenever bill is issued and the maturity, at the time of maturity, that means after 2 months, right, if G refused to give the money or refused to pay the bills receivable, then it is called a dishonor of bills receivable, and the charges of dishonor is also levied on R. First of all, it is given by G, but right now G has no money, so the charges of dishonored of bills receivable also levy on the R, and the full amount, that is, see, if the charges is, say for example, 50 rupees and the 10,000 rupees is the already due amount, right, so total now R has to take from G rupees 10,050. These charges is right now given by R because G has no money. So refusing or dishonored of bills receivable also charge amount, and that is charge amount is paid by right now the owner or the writer of the or the holder of the bills receivable. Okay, and bills receivable 50 rupees is now paid by R, and then R take from G 10,050 rupees in future. That is, dishonor charge is also levied on right now G, but it is paid by R. Okay, so here dishonor of bill, this is the transaction of bill as well as dishonor of bill. Now it is also all these transactions, bills receivable, dishonor, all the transactions are the special transactions, and that's why it is recorded to journal proper. Fifth, bad debts. If now, after that, after this, if G has refused that he is insolvent, G has refused that I have no money, or he declared as an insolvent, government declare or court declare him, that is G, as an insolvent, then what? 50 paisa per rupee will received from the receiver of the G. If the sum says that 50 paisa per rupee, that means was 50%, whatever the amount is due, the 50% amount is received from receiver of G to R. The remaining 50% is called a bad debts. Okay, so here bad debts is also a special transaction. Whenever G is refused after 15 days, now if R goes to G and G becomes an insolvent, and he received and he paid only 5,025 to R, the remaining 5,025 is bad debts. And these bad debts is also recorded in these special transactions, that is in the journal proper. Now, 6 points, endorsement of bills receivable. Yes, what is the endorsement of bills receivable? Again, R write a bill on G. And here, see, first R sold the goods to G, right? 10,000 rupees, okay? After 15 days, R goes to G, G refused to give the money. R draw or issue a bill on G, G sign it and accept it and return it to R. Now, R want money compulsory, because R has a business and R has to pay this amount to somebody else, that is someone V. See, some V, R has to pay the amount, same amount, that is 10,000 to V. Then what? See, he want money from G, and if G pays 10,000, then directly R paid to V. Okay, now what? Here, right now, G is not given any money because he has no money, and R drew a bill on it. Okay, and R, G is sign it and accept it and return it to R. Now, this particular bill, that is bills receivable, is a negotiable instrument. It's called a negotiable instrument. Okay, and it's just like a check. Okay, if I'm giving a check to him or he gives me a check, okay, and I am giving that particular check to another person, okay, that is called a bearer check. Okay, and here R has a bills receivable which is issued by him and signed by the G. It is endorsed to V. Bills receivable, this bills receivable is endorsed to V, 10,000 rupees. And here endorsement is there. It is called an endorsement. And this type of endorsements of bill, that is also special transactions, and that is also recorded in journal proper. Here bills receivable signed, and this bills receivable here right now on the hand of the R. Okay, and now R has to pay some amount to V, 10,000 same amount. Okay, so that particular bill receivable is endorsed to V, R endorsed to V. Now what? At the maturity, after 2 months, V goes to G directly. V don't goes to R, and R not goes to G for this bill. The holder of this bill right now is V, because R issue it, G sign it, return back to R, R endorse it to V, and now V directly after 2 months directly goes to G for the money, 10,000 rupees, because V is now holder and G is the sign, or you can say acceptor. Okay, so here G has to pay 10,000, and at that time endorsement as well as the maturity is complete. Okay, so the endorsement of the bills receivable is also recorded here. 7 point, loss of goods due to fire, that is also a special transactions, accident, theft, etc. And the last point is depreciation. What is depreciation? See, we already seen what is depreciation in chapter number 1, that is the terms of the accounting. Okay, whatever the amount is decreased due to any of the reason, due to any of the reason means due to uses, due to just only the time varying on the basis of these, if the price or the value of the assets is decreased, that means it's a depreciation. On the basis of any of the reason, if the value of the assets is decreased, that means it is called a depreciation, and that is also a special transaction. That's why it is recorded to journal proper. This is only just for example, this 8 point is given, more than 8 point here, it is considered in this journal proper. So whatever the special transactions other than these also are recorded in journal proper, which we will see in illustration number 2. Some transactions is given and we will discuss about that in illustration number 2. Okay, so first of all, I hope you all understand this procedure, and this procedure is very important. Please keep in mind, because this is a for bills receivable, or you can say for bills, a special chapter is also there in second part, and at that time also we have to also know in detail about the bills payable, bills receivable, and all these things. Okay, so if you don't understand right now, then please again repeat this video 1 or 2 times for understanding this, because if you know the procedure of this bills receivable or bills payable, then it is better to understand these transactions as well as these journal entries. Okay, so first of all, I am reading the question now. Illustration number 2. So, illustration number 2. Record the following in the journal proper of Sri Amarnath. Okay. See, the new marker is there, that's why if the writing is not properly seen, then please zoom it, or whatever I'm saying, please write down like right now at that time. Illustration number 2. October 1, 2017. Date. Particulars. LF. Debit credit. First, give goods of rupees 1500 in charity. So it's our donation, right? So charity account debit, or you can say donation account debit, that is our expenses. Okay, all expenses are debited. So here the charity is our expense, that's why charity account is debited. 2017 October 1st, charity is our expense, that's why charity account debit 1500 to. See here, all goods goes out other than sales or purchase return must be credited to purchase account. See, I told you at the time of journal entries at the chapter, in the chapter number 4, whenever all goods goes out other than sales or purchase return, that is a special transactions, in that case the goods goes out, at that time always purchase is credited. Here right now we have to credit purchase account. Goods given in a charity, goods given as a free sample, goods taken away for the personal use, goods destroyed by fire, theft, all these things, okay, accident, whatever the goods goes out other than sales or purchase return must be credited to purchase account. Okay, so here to purchase account 1500, and narration, write down the narration. Goods being goods of rupees 1500 given for the charity, goods of rupees 1500 given in the charity. Okay, so here your first transaction is over. Now the second one, distributed goods of rupees 3000 as a free sample. Again goods goes out for the advertisement as a free sample, right? And that's why advertisement is our expense. Whenever we are giving a goods as a free sample, that is our income. Okay, sorry, that is our expense, and that expense must be debited. So advertisement is our expense. So the date is 2nd
एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्सपेंस अकाउंट डेबिट। अमाउंट इज 3000 टू अगेन गुड्स गोज आउट अदर देन सेल्स और परचेज रिटर्न दैट इज अ स्पेशल ट्रांजेक्शंस ऑफ गुड्स गोज आउट इज रिकॉर्डेड क्रेडिटेड टू परचेज अकाउंट सो टू परचेज अकाउंट एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्सपेंस अकाउंट डेबिट 3000 टू परचेज अकाउंट 3000 being narration being goods of rupees 3000 given as a free sample being goods of rupees 3000 given as a free sample now the third one took goods of rupees 2500 from the business for the personal use again goods goes for the personal use that is drawings whatever amount or whatever kind or whatever goods we have taken or the owner taken away from the business for their personal use that is called drawings drawings definition is any kind any cash or any goods taken away for the personal use by the owner from the business that is called a drawings and here goods is taken away for the personal use the amount is 2500 and the date is 3rd October so here 3rd October drawing account debit Again, goods goes out other than sales or purchase return must be credited to purchase account. To purchase account being goods of rupees 25,000, sorry, goods of rupees 2500 withdrawn for the personal use. Being goods of rupees 2500 withdrawn for personal use okay I hope you complete this now fourth one a bill of rupees 4000 accepted by Priyanka was dishonored on maturity date again see the working note here I want to explain the same full thing full transaction bill of rupees 4000 accepted by Priyanka and we are Amarnath see here the heading journal proper in the books of Sri Amarnath for October 2017 journal proper in the books of Sri Amarnath for the month of for the October 2017 okay here see the working note date is 4th see a bill of rupees 4000 accepted by Priyanka means what Amarnath now we are Amarnath Amarnath issue or you can say drone bills issuable on Priyanka she accept and return that particular bill but after the maturity or you can say at the maturity
Priyanka refused to pay money because she has no money. At the time of maturity, now the bill is dishonored. See, I told you at the time of cash book. If bills receivable is dishonored, or you can say not bills receivable. See, here at that time check is dishonored. First, if the party give us a check and we will record it on the receipt side, on the debit side, or you can say on the receipt side. Why? Because bank is the receiver, and that's why here receipt is there. Check is received by us, that's why it's our receipt, and that's why it is recorded on the debit side. Always whenever check is received, we have to record on the debit side of the cash book, bank column cash book. But now at the same time, after 2 to 3 days, if check is dishonored, then same amount will recorded on the payment side, that is on the opposite side, and the party name we are returned here. Okay, at that time I told you in 2 column or in 3 columnar cash book, whenever the check is dishonored, we just have to write down on the opposite side the amount, same amount, and the party name. Okay, see here again, if bill receivable is drawn, whenever the bill receivable is drawn, what is the entry? If bill receivable is drawn before, see, whenever it is issue, whenever it is drawn, what is the general entry? Here the entry is bills receivable account. Debit amount is 4000 to Priyanka account. 4000. Whenever bills receivable is drawn, or whenever the bills receivable is issued, what is the entry? Bills receivable account debit to Priyanka account. But right now, after here in the October month, 4th October, the bill is matured, and here Amarna, that is the owner of the business, goes to Priyanka and give the BR, that is bills receivable, but she refused because she has no money and she refused to pay the money, and that at that time right now here the bill is dishonored, and now we have to write down the journal entry of dishonored of the bill. See, the dishonor entry is always reverse entry. At the time of cash book, I told you whenever the check is given or taken away or received, then we will record it on the receipt side. But at the same time, after 2 to 3 days, if the check is dishonored, we have to write down on the opposite side. Only the reverse entry we have to make. Same way, the dishonored word is there, we have to make the reverse entry. If the entry of issue of the bill receivable is this, then the entry of dishonor of the bill, that will ask in this example question number, date number 4, here the entry is just reverse entry at the time of dishonor of BR. See, what is the entry? Reverse entry is there. Whatever the reverse entry, here I am writing out 4th. What is the reverse entry of these? At the time of issue, this entry is there. At the time of dishonor, reverse entry. We have to write down reverse entry of this entry. Okay, so what is the reverse? Priyanka account is credited here. So Priyanka account is debited right now. So Priyanka account debit with the amount, same amount, 4000 to bills receivable is dishonored. That's why bills receivable account 4000 being
narration. Being Priyanka's bill of rupees 4,000 dishonored. Being Priyanka's bill of rupees 4,000 dishonored. So this is the transaction. Please write down this working note also to better understanding of this transaction. So please write down this. 4-10-2017, Amarnath issued drone bills receivable on Priyanka. Priyanka sign, accept and return it. Now, if the bill receivable is drone at the time of bill receivable is drone. At the time of bills receivable is drawn, bills receivable account debit to Priyanka account 4,000 is the entry. But now, right now, at the maturity, after 1-3 months, tenure of 1-3 months, the bills is at the maturity, bill is dishonored. At the time of dishonor of the BR, reverse entry of this we have to write down, and that is our question. If here in the 4th October, a bill of rupees 4,000 accepted by Priyanka. Bill of rupees 4,000 accepted by Priyanka, that is the entry of this is already in our books of accounts before 2 months. Okay, now right now it is dishonored. What dishonored? On the maturity day. Today is the maturity day, and today right now on 4th October the bill is dishonored, and that's why at the time of dishonor of the bill, reverse entry is there. Priyanka account debit 4,000 to bills receivable account. Okay, so this is the entry. Fourth, now first of all, write down these. Fifth point, an amount of rupees 3,500 receivable from Naresh cannot be collected from him. Cannot be collected means what? Whatever the amount is receivable, that means he is a debtor. An amount 3,500 receivable from Naresh, that means here Naresh is our debtor. The meaning of this sentence is Naresh is our debtor. Now what? Cannot be collected from him, that means what? Now it is bad debts. The debtors Naresh refused to pay any money from due from him. Okay, so here if he is refusing, that means here it's a bad debt. Okay, and always bad debts is recorded as a special transaction in a journal proper. So here fifth, amount of rupees 3,500 collected from Naresh, that is our debtors, now he is refused, that means net cannot be collected from him. So bad debts account debit, because bad debts is our loss, it's not our expense, it's our loss. Okay, so bad debts account debit. Naresh. Naresh is the party name, that's why to Naresh account. Being bad debts of rupees 3,500 due from Naresh. Fifth, over. Now the sixth one. A bill of rupees 2,000 endorsed in favor of Pankaj against bad debts. Sorry, debts of rupees 2,050. Here, two entries are there. We have to understand this transaction also in the working note, because this is not a single transaction. It's a link transaction. Six, 10, 17. Bill of rupees 2000 endorsed in favor of Pankaj against debt of rupees 2050. Amarnath, Pankaj. Here, first of all, what is the basic? Here Amarnath has to take money from Pankaj rupees 2050. That is, Amarnath has to collect rupees 2050 from Pankaj. Now on this day, that is on 6th, a bill of rupees 2000 endorsed in favor of Pankaj against debt of rupees 2050. See here. Sorry, V.R. Amarnath and Pankaj, see the relation between the person, that is owner, and the person name given in the question. First of all, we have to know Pankaj is our debtor or Pankaj is our creditor. What is the entry is right now? First, we have to understand what is the relationship between the Amarnath and Pankaj, that is owner and the party name given in the question. A bill of rupees 2000 endorsed. Amarnath endorsed the bill. Amarnath endorsed the bill of Pankaj of rupees 2000. See, endorsement means what? Whatever amount is taken from someone, say for example X, Amarnath write down a bills receivable Amarnath draw a bills receivable on X. X sign and return it to Amarnath. Now, Amarnath has to pay some money, that is 2050. Amarnath has to pay 2050 to Pankaj. That means what? Pankaj right now is our creditor. Pankaj is, in this case, Amarnath's creditor. And Amarnath, this bill, return on X, Amarnath endorses this 2000 rupees bill to Pankaj for the debt. Here, whatever amount due from Pankaj, whatever amount due to Pankaj is now only pay through endorsement of bills receivable. Okay, so here Amarnath first, in the first transaction, Amarnath issue a bills receivable on someone, that is say for example X person, right? That bill is signed and accepted by X and returned back to Amarnath. Now Amarnath, this bill, Amarnath has to pay some money, that is 2050 to Pankaj. But Amarnath has also not money, but Amarnath has bills receivable of 2000 rupees. He has, yes. And at that time right now, Amarnath endorsed that particular bills receivable to Pankaj. Okay, so that is 2000 rupees is indirectly given by the Amarnath to Pankaj of rupees 2000. And right now, Pankaj is not refused to take these bills also. So here, what is the entry? Pankaj is the receiver or giver right now? Receiver. Because Amarnath endorsed to Pankaj. See the entry. A bill of rupees 2000 endorsed in favor of Pankaj. Endorse in favor of Pankaj, that means endorse to Pankaj. Endorse to Pankaj means what? Pankaj is the receiver. So debit the receiver account here. I hope you complete that. So right now I'm The date is 6th October. Pankaj is the receiver here. That's why Pankaj account is debit. The amount is 2000. No. Amount is total amount due to Pankaj, that is 2050. 2050. But bills receivable is our assets. If bills receivable is issued or drawn, then bills receivable account is debited to X account. That is the entry. But if it is endorsed, okay, so bills receivable goes out to Pankaj. It is endorsed. Here, bills receivable is one sheet, one page of the bills receivable account, and it is here endorsed or it is given to Pankaj. That's why that is assets. Okay, and assets goes out from the business, that's why credited to bills receivable account. $2,000 only, and the remaining 50 is discount received by us, that is by Amarnath. So discount received is our income, so discount account credit 50 rupees. Again, Pankaj is the receiver, so debit the receiver. Bills receivable is our assets, that's why bills goes out. Goods go, assets goes out, that's why to bills receivable account 2000, and we received a discount of rupees 50 indirectly. That's why discount is our income, that's why to discount account 50. And narration being bill of rupees 2000 endorsed to Pankaj on the due of rupees 2050, being bill of rupees 2000 endorsed to Pankaj on the due of rupees 2050. Okay, so the sixth entry is over. Now the seventh one, goods of rupees 5000 were destroyed by fire, for which the insurance company accepted a claim of 4000. Goods of rupees 5000. See, this is the same transactions we discussed it as a special transaction in journal entries, journal entry chapter number 4, right? So I hope you all know about that, so I'm not detailing it here. Goods of rupees 5000 burned by fire. So here goods goes out of rupees 5000, that is goods goes out other than sales or purchase return. That's why it is credited to purchase account. Here 4000, insurance company accepted a claim of rupees 4000. That's why here insurance company, I have to take amount 4000 from insurance company. So at that time, right now, insurance company account debit. Okay, so right now is insurance company is our debtor. I have to take money from insurance company of rupees 4000. That's why insurance company account debit. Amount is receivable from insurance company. That's why insurance company account debit 4000. 5000 goods goes out, credited purchase account, but now 1000 is loss. Here 5000 goods burned. Amount receivable from insurance company is 4000, so remaining 1000 is the loss of the business, and that's why it is recorded to loss due to fire account debit. Always all expenses and losses, nominal account rule, always all expenses and losses are debited. Okay, so here 7, insurance company account debit 4000. Insurance company account debit 4000. 1000 is lost due to fire. Loss due to fire account debit 1000. First, insurance company's account debit 4000. Loss due to fire account debit 1000. And goods goes out of rupees 5000 other than sales or purchase return. That's why it is credited to purchase account 5000, insurance company account debit 4000 because amount is receivable from insurance company, that's why it is debited. Loss is our expense or loss, you can say it's a nominal account, and nominal account always debited. Loss due to fire account debit 1000, and to purchase account here 5000. Okay, so here 5000 is recorded and being narration same as a question, being goods of rupees 5000 destroyed by fire and insurance company accepted a claim of rupees 4000. Being goods of rupees 5000 destroyed by fire and insurance company accepted a bill of accepted a claim of rupees 4000. Being goods of rupees 5000 destroyed by fire, insurance company accepted a claim of rupees 4000. Okay, so 7th entry is over. Now the 8th one. Purchased a furniture of rupees 8000 against the goods costing 7000. Purchased a furniture of rupees 8000. See, whatever we are purchasing, assets or goods, if goods are purchased, we have to record to purchase account. If furniture is purchased, we have to debit it to furniture account. Okay, that you already know. Whatever goods is purchased, purchase account debit. Furniture or any assets is purchased, particular assets account debit. Here, purchase of furniture, that's why furniture account is debited of rupees 8000. But on the behalf of the purchase, on the consideration of the purchase of the furniture, what we are giving? We are not giving any cash. If we are giving any cash, then it is recorded to cash book. 8000 furniture of rupees 8000 purchase, and if we are paying cash or check, then it is recorded to what? To cash book. Okay, but right now in this case we are not giving rupee any cash. On the consideration of purchase of furniture, we are giving a goods on behalf of or on the consideration of the purchase of furniture of rupees what? Of rupees 7000. So whatever amount is goes out from our business, that is recorded, not recorded whatever amount is coming into the business. See, furniture costing 8000 is now come into my business costing 8000, but for that particular 8000, what I am paying 7000 only. I am purchasing the furniture of rupees 8000, that is okay, but for 8000 I am paying 8000. No, I am just giving a goods of rupees 7000. Okay, so here we have to record that furniture purchase is not for 8000. Whatever I am paying for it, that is my purchase. Whatever I am paying for the particular furniture, that is my purchase price of furniture. Amount, whatever the amount is given, 8000, 10000, whatever the cost price or purchase price is given into the question, but what we are paying, that is the purchase price of for us. 8000 furniture of rupees 8000 we are purchasing, but on the consideration of that particular furniture we are giving a goods of rupees only 7000. So here 7000 is only the consideration, as well as 7000 is the cost price of furniture also, not 8000. So at that time ignore 8000. Okay, so here furniture of rupees 7000 coming to the business, and goods goes out other than sales or purchase return. This is not our sales, this is not our purchase return, this is a special transaction
in which we are just giving our goods and taking out some other asset, that is furniture. Okay, so 8th entry, furniture comes into the business, that's why furniture account debit 7000, not 8000, because we are paying only 7000 as a goods. Okay, and goods goes out, that's why to purchase account 7000. Purchase of furniture 8000 against the costing 7000, that means here 7000 goods goes out, that's why purchase account is created 7000, and also furniture is account is also debited with 7000. No profit, no loss. Don't write profit or loss here. Whenever you are exchanging any assets on behalf of the goods, that is goods of the business, okay, so at that time no profit, no loss, please don't record that. Only record whatever the cost price of our goods, we have to record that amount. Whatever the amount of purchase of assets is given, ignore that. Okay, so here furniture of rupees 7000 comes into the business, that's why furniture account debit to purchase account 7000, being goods of rupees 7000 given for the purchase of furniture, being goods of rupees 7000 given for the purchase of furniture. So here the illustration number 2 is over. So now make the total first. Draw a full line. Another second line. Write down total here. And make the total. Whatever the debit side total is the credit side total. The total is 28550. Again the total is here, same total always. Whatever the debit amount is there at each and every entry, whatever the debit is there, the credit is also there, so the total amount is always equal. And for the equal amount we have to also draw a second line for the tally. Here it is the sign, second line is the sign to tally the total. Here the total is tally 28550 on the debit and credit side. Okay, so here your illustration number 2 is over. Now see the special another transactions is also given, and we have to understood that all the transactions, and that we will discuss in our next session. But right now the time for homework. See, I hope you complete exercise 1, 2, 3, question number 1, 2, 3. I was give you in the homework in the last session that exercise 8 exercise 8 question number 1 2 3 is our last session homework. Now question number 4 5 and 6, see here. Question number 4 is just opening entry, all the opening balance of the accounts, all the accounts is given, and you have to write down the opening journal entry, journal proper, that we will discuss in our last session. That's why you have to write down these opening journal entries. And second is the normal journal proper for bills payable, bills receivable, purchase return, sales return, all these books, that is all subsidiary books are not kept by the owner into the business, and that's why that transaction also recorded in journal proper. That is also we discussed in our illustration number 1 in our last session. And the sixth one, record the following transaction in the following journal proper of the Rakesh, that is the amount, that is the
transactions like this is here given in exercise sum number 6. Okay, 6 and 7 also, but right now we are only, I am giving you just the question number 6 for this. Okay, so we will discuss the remaining topics, that is transactions of the inter-account transfer, then closing entries, then adjustment entries, rectification of errors, all types of transactions, all the entries we will discuss in our next session, and the remaining sum also we will discuss 7, 8, 9. From that one sum is also discussed in our next session. Okay, so till that, just you have to read all the next remaining topics whatever we discuss in our next session. So here the homework also, here you have to read all the topics, that is topic number 4, transactions of inter account transfer, then point number 5, closing entries, point number 6, adjustment entries, and point number 7, rectification of errors. You have to read that also and write down these illustration in your illustration book, and write down these 3 sums in your exercise book. Okay, so here I am complete my lecture. So thank you class, have a nice day, bye bye.